Hi friends, welcome back to the brand new series on Angular Zero to Hero, a perfect Angular guide for beginners. In my last video, I have explained about components in Angular and how we can create and use it in our application. In this video, I'm going to explain about one of the most important topics, data binding. Data binding in Angular can be defined as the communication between the TypeScript component and the HTML template. Based on the direction of data flow, data binding in Angular can be divided into three types. String interpolation. If you want to send data from the TypeScript component to the HTML template, we can use string interpolation. Let's see an example. Let me declare a variable first name and assigning to a value Surendar. And I want to use this variable in my template and show it in the browser. So I can use string interpolation. We use double curly braces to show the variable value in the HTML. When I change the value, I can see it is getting updated immediately. There is another way to bind the value from TypeScript component to the HTML template. That is using property binding. We know HTML tags have different properties. For example, an image tag may have properties like source, alt, width, etc. And a paragraph tag may have properties like inner text. So we can directly bind a value to these properties. But property binding use square bracket like this. So if you want to dynamically switch an image source, we can do it easily using property binding. Mostly string interpolation can be used to output some value in the HTML template, and the property binding can be used to change any property in the HTML. So we have seen the ways to send data from the TypeScript component to the HTML template. Now let's see how we can pass data from the HTML template to the TypeScript component. For this, we have a data binding concept called event binding. Let's see an example on that. Let me create a text box using input type text. Now I want to send this value to the component while user is typing. So I can bind the input event of the text box to a function and can pass the event like this. Please note, event binding uses parentheses, but the property binding uses square brackets. Let me create this function in the component. Now I'm getting the event in the component and can get the value of the text box using event.target.value. Let me console that so that we can see the output. This is how we can pass the data to the TypeScript component from the HTML template. Event binding can also be used to listen for the user actions like keystrokes, mouse movements, clicks, etc. And the last type of data binding is the specialty of Angular, two-way data binding. This happens in both the directions simultaneously. Assume we have a text box and we need to default the text box value using a value from the component. And if user changes the value, it should be sent back to the component. Ideally, we may have to use property binding to bind the value property, and then we have to bind an input event to a function, and in that function we need to update the variable again. But in Angular, we can easily do it. We have an inbuilt directive called ngModel. We'll be seeing about directives soon, but right now let's see how we can use two-way binding. We shall remove the property binding as well as event binding from here. Instead, we shall use the combination of both. We call this as banana in the box. So inside this, we shall use the special directive ngModel and bind that to a variable. If I save this and open the app, we shall see the app is broken. We can see the error can't bind to ngModel since it is in a known property of input. Because ngModel directive is part of another module in Angular called forms module. So we need to import the forms module in our root module. Only then we can use this directive. Beginners often forget to include this, and so they may face this error. Now we can see the app is working again. The defaulted value is showing in the text box, and if I update this, the value is going back to the component also. Data binding is an important concept because we use this concept a lot in our applications. So practice well on this. So it is task time now. Try creating an application similar to this. Here you need to use all type of bindings like string interpolation, property binding, event binding, and two-way binding. I have a text box and a button. If an user clicks the button after entering any value or without entering any value, we need to verify the value of the text box. If the value is equal to the text submitted, then the button should be disabled. If no value or any other values, then the button should not be disabled. Let me give some idea. We have disabled property in button, and we are also having click event in button through which we can call a function. Try this task. If you face any difficulties or have any doubts, post it in the comment section. If you are not able to achieve this for some reason, you can get the solution code from the GitHub. I have provided the URL in the description. Okay, next we shall move to directives. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe, press bell button and stay tuned. Thank you.